Hello, I'm Dennis Kirsch from the Ultrafast Fiber Lasers Group, and I'm pleased to present to you my current research, which is focused on the generation of ultra-short laser pulses at around 2 micron, the shortwave infrared spectral region. Ultra-short pulses at this wavelength region are useful, for example, for biomedical spectroscopy and microscopy, for LiDAR, as well as for surgery and plastics processing. Furthermore, there are promising pump sources for the generation of mid-IR wavelengths. The second key aspect is that it has a monolithic structure. All fiber lasers are beneficial over bulk counterparts due to their compactness and maintenance-free operation. But fiberized components for the 2 micron region are typically lossy, expensive, and occasionally rare. So are CSAMs, which are the standard used lateral absorbers, which have also quite a low damage threshold. These factors restrain the design flexibility and limit the output power performance. On these grounds, we have designed a tunable ultrafast tulium-doped fiber laser, which you can see here. The first unique feature of our laser's design is that it gets mode-locked without a distinguished lateral absorber. Neither a CSAM nor nonlinear polarization rotation is necessary. Instead, we employ the self-mode-locking capability of tulium ions itself. By balancing between the length of excited and unexcited lengths of active fiber, we get a remarkable short pulse duration and fast repetition rate. Previous works on this field needs the support of self-phase modulation, which leads to picosecond pulses and a slow repetition rate. Our design delivers 70 milliwatt average output power with soliton pulses as short as 350 femtoseconds, repeated with 45 megahertz. The pulses contain over 1 nanojoule of pulse energy, or 3 kilowatt of peak power, and are unimpaired by Q-switch modulation. The second aspect of our laser is its tunability. It can be tuned from 1840 to 1970 nanometer. This range is one of the broadest reported without an actual filter in the cavity. It's the only one with self-weight modulation. Responsible for this is the variable output coupler we have employed in the cavity. It alters the separation of two evanescently coupled fibers, and hence it can be tuned the coupling ratio. This video represents the continuous tunability of our laser by just screwing on the variable output coupler and changing the coupling ratio from 90 to 10%. Now let's go through the individual components of our laser setup. It starts here with the pump diode, and then an erbium-doped fiber laser cavity, which is generating our pump light at 1.5 micron. After that, the actual tulium oscillator starts with a dichroic coupler here. It combines the pump light with our signal at around 2 micron. Thereafter follows the tulium-doped active fiber, which is the blue one here. It has quite a high doping concentration and a small core to increase the intensity for lateral absorption. We employ half a meter of length, and therefore 5 centimeters are unexcited with maximum pump power. We attribute the high lateral absorption to a high amount of tulium clusters in the tulium fiber. Investigations are ongoing, but we hope to design a fiber with even more lateral absorption. Thereafter follows an isolator, which is this one, for unidirectionality. And then after that, a polarization controller is employed to restore the polarization after one round trip. After that, we have our variable coupler, which is this handy box with a micrometer screw to change the output coupling. This port closes the ring to the dichroic coupler, and this port is where the output comes from. We believe that this exquisite design has the potential to broaden the applicability, for example, for rough tasks and for cost critical. We aim further to increase the subtle absorption behavior of our tulium-doped fiber And beyond that, we want to employ polarization maintaining fiber to get rid of the polarization controller and further reduce the expenses of fiber components by utilizing a sigma cavity. Further advantages would be that this can reduce Kelly sidebends and shape mode locking. Through an advanced dispersion management, we want to transit to a dissipative soliton for further output power performance. Since all components then are all in fiber, they have a very high damage threshold, which means there's plenty of room for further power enhancement. With this, I come to the end. Thank you for your attention.